As we heard in our gospel reading, this is sometimes called Mary's Sunday. Her very distinct personhood really permeates the verses of Luke, telling us again that remarkable story of a young teenage girl facing insurmountable odds of her day. Luke reminds his readers how the Old Testament prophecies were fulfilled, and that the time has come. The waiting is over. A betrothed young woman in a small Galilean village in Nazareth, where the angel greets her as a favored one. She's told not to be afraid and delivers the startling message that she has been chosen by God to bear a child who will be named Jesus, which means God saves. I think the real focus here is on the miraculous power of God through the Holy Spirit to overcome human limitations. This theme is further emphasized as Gabriel calls attention to the pregnancy of Mary's cousin, Elizabeth, who is thought to be barren and could never have a child. For nothing will be impossible with God. Mary's response, "Let it be with me according to your word," is one of faithful and courageous obedience. Mary is the recipient of God's grace, serving as an example of faith and an absolute trust in God. She is that wonderful example to us. These first few verses of Luke about Mary are filled with the reality of ancient prophecies and with an example of great faith on the part of just one poor young teenager. So this is the incredible story of Mary, soon to be the mother of God's Son, we call Jesus. And for us today, beyond this extraordinary, unbelievable account from a faraway land 2,000 years ago, is there any value for us now? Any meaning? Any relevance? Or maybe another way of saying this, so what difference, what meaning does this ancient, hard-to-believe story have for us? Two thoughts about the story. I'm sure that you have your own 2 cents worth to throw in about what you think this is all about. But first, I'm still in complete awe. The one who created the universe, who created our earth, our island home, chose to use a human being to reveal the true nature of God Almighty. Mary was that instrument, that human instrument God used to show who God truly is. Secondly, each time I read and hear this powerful beginning of Luke, I'm struck by Mary's faith. Maybe an innocent faith, but maybe not. Maybe a faith so strong that that we would like to have some of that. A quote from Kyle Childress in 2001, and I quote, "I love the way Luke and Matthew begin their Gospels. Both tell us of these plain, ordinary people, Mary and Joseph, who obey God and through whom God begins the extraordinary work of salvation for all people. Traditionally, the church has called Mary the first disciple. She was the first to believe and obey. And even though Luke tells her story with a bit more drama than Matthew's telling of Joseph's, we will still get the message that here was an ordinary young woman, really a teenage girl, who embodied extraordinary courage and faith in God to be able to say, let it be to me according to your will. Or maybe put more mundanely, Mary said yes. More than one theologian of the church over centuries has said that the great miracle that surrounded the birth of Jesus was not the virgin birth, but that Mary and Joseph believed and obeyed. So for me, one of my takeaways from this incredible account from Luke is really a series of questions that I'm confronted with. Each time I read these verses, those questions sort of come from the back of my mind. Is my faith, is my obedience unconditional like that of Mary? Or, in my case, in Rayford Hines' case, so often, is it strong, obedient, or is my faith based on convenience, or does it not interfere with my schedule or my wishes? These are hard questions that I struggle with, knowing though that I need to ask God to strengthen my faith and my obedience. And I know the Holy Spirit is there to help me. As we end these words about Mary, may her witness and her example lead us into a deeper, stronger faith and obedience of Jesus as we serve him in the days, in the weeks, and the months, and the years to come as individual disciples and as his church. Amen.
Amen. Amen.